Hello students, I am Renu Verma and in today's video we are going to learn comparison of adjectives, degrees of adjectives. So let's get started. Read the given sentences carefully. 1. She is wise. Next, he is wiser than her. And next, I am the wisest. So, here I have taken three sentences. Why? To tell you only, the adjective wise is in positive degree. While in sentence 2, the adjective wiser is in comparative degree. And in sentence 3, the adjective wisest is in superlative degree. So there are 3 degrees of adjectives. There are 3 degrees of adjectives. What are they? Positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. Positive means simple, an adjective, no comparison, no superiority, only an adjective has been given in a sentence. As you can see in example number 1, in sentence number 1, she is wise. So here no comparison is being made. Okay, so whenever we use simply an adjective in a sentence, so the degree of adjective that is called, that is positive degree. Next one is comparative degree. As comparative means comparison. So, in comparative degree, a comparison is made between two things, between two persons. As you can see the example, he is wiser than her. So, here a comparison is being made between two people. Next is superlative degree. So what is in superlative degree? It shows super in a group, in a class, in atmosphere, in world, anything can be there. So more than two people, whenever a comparison is made for more than two people, then the degree that is used, that is superlative degree. I hope you understood. So now, I am going to teach you some rules. By following them, by learning them, you can easily form comparative degree and superlative degree. And then, you will not face any spelling difficulty. So let's get started. Rules. Formation of comparative and superlative. So for formation we have few rules. Okay, so rule number one is most adjectives of one syllable are formed the comparative by adding er and superlative by adding est to the positive. So, you must have been seen, you must have been studied so many examples like that in which we form comparative and superlative by adding ER as a last letter and EST as a last letter in superlative. Means comparative, in comparative we add ER to make their comparative degree and in superlative we add EST to make their superlative degree. Okay, in positive degree, whenever we add ER or EST to make their comparative and superlative, so for that we need to check the spelling. If there is one syllable, then this rule will be followed. Because in not in all words we can do the same thing. So for this, we need to check the spelling. If the word is of single syllable or not? If the word is of single syllable, then obviously we are going to follow this rule. So, example, sweet, sweeter, sweetest. Positive is sweet. I added er to make comparative, and then I added est to make superlative. Why? Because it is a single syllable word, sweet. I hope you understood. One more example. Kind, same. One syllable word, kind, kinder, kindest. Hope it's clear to you. Now, rule number 2. When the positive ends in E, means last letter is E, then only R and ST are added to make their comparative and superlative. As brave, last letter is E. Brave, braver, bravest. Okay? Hope it's clear to you. Fine, finer, finest. So in these two words, we have E as a last letter in positive degree. So to make their comparative and superlative, I don't need to add E again. Okay? This is also one syllable word. Okay? And they are already having E. So don't add E again. Just add R and ST to make their comparative and superlative. I hope this is clear. Next rule. When the positive ends in Y. Y is last letter. Preceded by a consonant. The Y is changed into I before adding ER or EST. Means last letter is Y and the nearest letter of Y is a consonant, not a vowel. So, to make their comparative degree and superlative degree, we convert Y into I. Example, happy, last letter is Y. So, we will convert into I. And then we will make it happier, happiest. Happy, happier, happiest. Y will be changed into I. And then ER and EST are added. Hope it's clear. Easy, easier, easiest. Same. Last letter is Y. And nearest letter of Y is a consonant. Then this rule will be followed. But if nearest letter is a vowel, then we are not going to change Y to I. Okay? Next rule. When the positive is a word of one syllable and ends in a single consonant. According to this rule, the word is of a single syllable and added with a single consonant. Last letter is also a consonant. So then we just double the consonant. Example, red. So last letter is D. D is a consonant and before it there is E, that is a vowel. Last letter hamara consonant hona chahiye aur just nearest letter hamara vowel hona chahiye aur word hamara single syllable wala hona chahiye. Then we will follow this rule. Like red, redder, reddest. Hot, hotter, hottest. Short word, last letter consonant, nearest letter of is vowel. Then this rule will be followed. We've just doubled the consonant letter. The last letter will be doubled. I hope this rule is clear. Next one. adjectives. Adjectives of more than one syllables. Then, comparative and superlative by adding more and most before the positive. If we have a long spelling word, more than one syllables are there. So then, we do not add ER and EST to make their plural. We add more and most to make their plural. For example, beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Two syllables are there. Okay? Beautiful, even three. So, we will add more and most to make their comparative and superlative. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. So, this time we are not going to do beautifuler, beautifulest. Hai na? We will do more beautiful, most beautiful. Difficult, more difficult, most difficult. I hope this one is also clear to you. Last rule. Some adjectives are having different comparative and different superlative degrees. Okay? So we need to learn them only. Like good, better, best. So we are not going to do gooder, goodest. Okay? And not we are going to do more good, most good. But we are going to do good, better, best. Same for old, older, oldest. Means this rule tells us there are few words that carry irregular comparative and superlative degrees. Irregular means totally different. We need to learn them. Okay? I hope this video will be very helpful for you. Please do like it, share it, and do not forget to subscribe our channel.